peace to the welter of war, to the planet that inflames the basest passions, Mars. As we see it today, so our ancestors saw it, red and forbidding. The influence of its nearness to the Earth drove men to the murkiest deeds. Mars demanded many a brutal sacrifice. Long before the invention of the telescope, the ancient astrologer studied the sky with crude instruments, and he carefully recorded his observations. At night, the red planet led him up the Martian path. He imagined that the path of Mars across the heavens was in the form of a loop, and the mystery of it all appalled him. Let's try and solve the mystery by taking a little trip. Mars is the planet coming next after the Earth in the order of distance from the Sun. Sometimes he's only 35 million miles away, on our doorstep, so to speak. Being in such intimate touch, it's an easy matter for a modern telescope to reveal what Mars has been trying to keep secret for ages, his wonderful system of channels stretching from pole to pole. The presence of water is shown by polar ice caps, and water is usually a sign of animal, if not human, life, though some humans don't take any water with them. The Martian year is 687 days, so Mars moves more slowly around the Sun than the Earth does. As a matter of fact, the Earth moves about twice as fast as the red planet, and that's why the ancients got such a distorted view of its path. While the Martian year is twice as long as ours, the actual planet is only half the Earth's size. It has two satellites, or hangers-on. They are really tiny moons revolving round it, and both are only a few miles across. With two moons, a night on Mars is a very strange phenomenon. It's the red glow of Mars, and no midget moustache or languid luck that has made him the god of war. And just as we think the Martians are warlike, they may think we're a very peaceful folk. Who knows? I don't, for one. And now...